12 Essential iPhone X Tips for Dealing with the Biggest Changes. From the Super Retina OLED screen and Face ID to Animoji, and the utter lack of a home button, there's a lot that's new in the iPhone X. But all that newness also brings a new way to use the iPhone, and some of the biggest changes will take some getting used to. In fact, some of these changes are guaranteed to throw you for a loop until you get accustomed to using Apple's new flagship. Here's how to get around the new iPhone X, so you can minimize the learning curve. By default, the iPhone X doesn't show how much battery life you have left as a percentage. Instead, you just see the icon and how full, or not, it is. If you don't want to guess how much juice you have, just swipe down from the top right of the screen to reveal the control center. The percentage appears only when you swipe down, and it disappears when you swipe back up. Because there's no home button on the iPhone X, you can no longer open the app switcher by double-pressing that button. Instead, you need to swipe up from the bottom of the screen, and then hold your finger on the display briefly to show your open apps. You can then swipe through apps just as you normally would. No, you can't just swipe up on an app while you're in the app switcher menu to quit an app. Apple purposely did this so that you wouldn't accidentally close an app, because getting to this menu already involves swiping up from the bottom of the screen. On the iPhone X, you just press and hold the screen briefly, and then you'll see a minus icon appear on each app. From there, you can either tap on that minus symbol to force quit the app, or swipe up on it like you're used to. With Touch ID now going the way of the dodo, Face ID is the quickest way to unlock your phone securely. Although we've found Face ID to be a bit slower than Touch ID, you don't have to wait around for the iPhone X to show you that the screen has unlocked. Just start swiping up on the screen even before you see the visual confirmation, and you'll get to the home screen faster. We also suggest making sure that the Raise to Wake setting is enabled in Settings. You'll find it in Display and Brightness. If you prefer to wake the phone yourself, we suggest tapping on the display rather than clicking on the iPhone X side button. It will make unlocking the phone with Face ID feel more seamless. You're accustomed to pressing the home button in combination with the iPhone side power button to take screenshots, but now that the home button is gone, it's actually just as easy. You just press and hold the side button while you press the volume up key. Well, the easiest way to summon Apple's assistant is to utter, "Hey, Siri," but if you'd rather not sound ridiculous in public, you can now just press and hold the side button to access that feature. You'll have to break your habit of swiping up from the bottom of the screen to turn on the flashlight, turn on Wi-Fi, brighten the screen and tweak other settings. You need to swipe down from the top right of the display, whether you're in portrait or landscape.